Hello, everyone. It is Saturday, May 26th in the year of our Lord 2012. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome, enjoying the relaxation and just being lazy. Nothing wrong with that at all. Start this one off early because so, we got friends coming over. Arlene and their lesser half, but still awesome man goat. Awesome people. So we'll be hanging out. But right now, we're going to bust out Dundee Pale Bock Lager, big and malty, out of Rochester, New York. I have never had any of these Dundee beers. We'll see how they are. That sounded like a shotgun. Pale Bock. So German-style Bock beer, huh? Yeah, we'll see how the New Yorkers do it. Wow, that is fizzy. Look at that. And I am drinking it out of a London Beer Festival pint glass. Yep. Makes me miss my Cambridge Beer Festival out in England that I used to go to all the time when I lived out there. To all you that are at the Cambridge Beer Festival, please drink one for me if you didn't already. Today is the last day of it, unfortunately. Oh, I missed that place. Ooh, wow. Very fizzy. Very, wow. Not a bad beer. Not bad at all. Kind of almost gave me a hiccup. Wow. That was unexpected. Lots of air in that one. It's an airhead. All right. How about some birthday shout-outs? Start right off with a man I worked in jolly old England. My friend Dave Horn. How you doing, brother? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're enjoying life. Haven't heard from you in a while. But drop a line. Hope you enjoy the show. And keep in touch, my man. Miss working with you. Next on the list, another one I worked with in jolly old England. This guy, definite acid trip. Awesome guy. My man, Randy Thrower. Happy birthday to you. I will never forget the time you took some of us. You took my man Anthony and I upstairs in We went up Newmarket to De Niro's, and you're like the pimp, you know. You had that VIP room and went up there and all them gorgeous ladies. Yeah, that was back in your single days. I remember that. But, dude, hope you're doing well. I know you're living in South Carolina, the land of cockroaches and humidity. But there's some nice areas out there, too. Downtown Charleston definitely rocks. North Charleston. Could drop a nuke on that and I wouldn't shed a tear. That dump. Ugh. Boy, yeah, so Randy, cheers and beers to you and happy birthday, my friend. Last I looked, the man still looks half his age. Crazy. I thought I aged well. Couldn't hold a candle to him. All right, and finally, one more birthday. I knew this young lady in high school, a couple years younger than me. Graduated with her sister Rachel. My friend Heather Boyle, she goes by now because she's happily married and doing well. I knew her as Heather Way, but Heather, hope you're doing well. And like I'd forget your birthday. Come on, I memorized the whole high school and still have it. I still got it up here. Definitely got the gift of numbers, thankfully. Haven't gone senile yet, so that's a blessing. But I hope you're having an awesome day. Hope you're doing well. And things are good here in Yeehaw, Texas. That's right. Where men and bulls run scared. All right. How about some additional... Oh, wait. We got a couple wedding anniversaries. My man, Travis Sample. Happy 11th anniversary to you, bro. Hope you're doing well. Hope you spoil your woman well the way I spoil mine. I'm sure you have. Otherwise, you wouldn't have already been married 11 years now. So... hope you two have an awesome, awesome day. And enjoy. And another wedding anniversary today. My man, Sherwin Allen. I'm sorry, Sherwin Marlin. Oh, jeez. I worked with Sherwin Allen in England. My man, Sherwin Marlin. 19 years today. Goes by quick, doesn't it? Happy anniversary, my friend. Hope you're enjoying it. Hope you're doing well. I love the story you laid out there on the old Facebook. That was cool how you guys met and everything. Phenomenal, man. Absolutely phenomenal. If I laid out how my wife and I met and everything, people would be like, oh, geez. Trust me, it's interesting. Some people have heard the story, and Farrah hates it when I tell the story, but I do it anyway. I'm good like that. So happy 19th anniversary to you. Cheers to my friends celebrating wedding anniversaries today, Travis and Sherwin, and your better halves. Like this love doctor says, treat them women right, and they'll treat you right. If not, they should have never been born. All right, how about some additional shout-outs? My man Tom Schultz. Worked with him in jolly old England. He told me about the term QA and what it stood for. Quivering anus. I'll never forget that. Dude, I use that term all the time, and people will just look at me like I'm smoking crack. Now, Tom's great people, but there's one problem. He's a Yankees fan. I'm not wearing a Red Sox hat, but I am wearing a Pawtucket Red Sox AAA affiliate hat today. So I bought that at McCoy Stadium a few years ago. Tom, always a pleasure chatting with you, and hope you're doing well, bro. So enjoy. And yes, I am wearing greatest running back ever, Barry the Man Sanders. All right, I know it's a little wrinkled, but that's all right. I don't iron, so whatever. I'm not out to impress anybody. I'm married to royalty. I got it good. So Tom, hope you're doing well. Love to hear from you. Always love bantering back and forth between the Sox and Skanks. It's a lot of fun. These next two, they're also living in Alabama. Yeah, I put an R on there on purpose. Otherwise known as Eastern Mississippi. Northern Florida? Sure, we can go with that too. Hamy, Billy Lorenzo, and his better half, Maria. How you two doing? Hope you're doing well. Miss you guys. Always a pleasure working with Hammy, as we call him, because that dude is like on speed. He's not on speed, but you would think he was, because he makes me, I mean, I'm pretty high energy type of guy, but wow. My man Hammy's something else. Unstoppable. Always on a mission from God. The man works his balls off. Hard worker. If everybody worked like him, there'd be nothing left to do. So Hammy, shout out to you. And always, he was always good at getting me beer when I needed it. When he went on the road, he'd bring some back for me. Much appreciated, my friend. If you were here, I'd give you a beer right now. Dundee Pale Bock Lager. Pretty good stuff. And Maria, I don't know how you handle him, but you know what? He's a great man. And you're a great lady. Real nice, real sweet. Beautiful. Hammy, how'd you get her? Ain't figured that one out yet. But then again, how'd I get my wife? So sometimes, you know, a little charm works, right? Hell yeah. All right, next on the list, my man Erik Lucas. Always a pleasure chatting with you. You and I always posting goofy stuff, cool stuff, things like that, and always keeping in touch. Well, definitely a pleasure working with you in jolly old England, and love hearing from you. I smell good food. Yeah, Erik, you know I'm always getting spoiled. That's right, always getting spoiled with some awesome cooking. But drop a line, let me know what you think of the show, and hope you have an awesome weekend. I know I will. And finally, my man Eric Moore. Another great man that I worked with in jolly old England. This guy was just the epitome of cool. Just calm, cool, collected, laid back. But great worker, great man. And always a pleasure to chat with him. A proud daddy indeed. Yep. It's good to be a good dad, huh? That we are. That's right. So, anyway, shout outs are done. How about we get to the license plate of the day? And I'm going to give a random fact of the day while I'm at it. See, this here license plate, California gold on blue license plate. Now, the random fact of the day is the fact that these were actually issued in late 1969. Okay? They're on a lot of vehicles from the 70s and 80s even, because these things were issued all the way up through 1986. And you still see a lot of cars with them nowadays, because they just put stickers on them every year. So a lot of gold on blue license plates around. Some are as old as 40. Now, this one, They originally did them in the 1-2-3 ABC format. So this one's a little bit later. This is probably from the 80s where they started putting the 7 digits because they ran out. Squeeze me. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, this license plate was pulled off of my friend Corey Henson. That's his name. I got to look him up. I worked with him in California many, many, many years ago. And I could not remember his name. Corey Henson. Awesome. I hope I find him. I haven't talked to him in about 17 years. I remember he gave me this license plate. And pretty good deal. It was pulled out. I want to say he had a 1983 Oldsmobile or something. Can't remember what year it was. 83, 84 is around that time frame. So, anyway, if anybody knows my friend Corey Henson, have him hit me up. I'm going to look for him on the old Facebook a little bit later. But in the meantime, we got to get to the song of the day, folks. Yes, Delilah's busy right now. She's over at her friend's birthday party. So, apologize for her not being on the show. I know it's a lot better when she is. Trust me. All right. We got a song that was written for me. That's right, for I am the Love Doctor. And this one is called I'm a Natural Born Lover by the great Muddy Waters, October 1954. Here we go. This is what blues is all about, my friends.
I'm a natural born lover.
Oh yeah.
I am a natural born lover.
Now see, Muddy Waters had so many great musicians in his bands. Obviously you got him on vocals and guitar. But you also got Little Walter on the harmonica, Otis Spann on the piano, Jimmy Rogers on the guitar, Willie Dixon on the bass, and this one's got Francis Clay on the drums. Those chess musicians were amazing. See, Little Walter, Otis Spann, Jimmy Rogers, they all recorded lots of their own blues songs. Willie Dixon as well, although Willie Dixon was more of a blues writer. He wrote so many great blues songs out there. Awesome stuff. This one's from Chess 1585. And there's Little Walter blasting away on the mouth harp. Mouth harp, mouth organ, whatever you want to call it. Blowing harp. Great music. This is what blues are all about, folks. So Muddy Waters recorded with Chess Records starting in 1947. Went all the way through 1967. 20 years with the same label. Incredible. They started out as Aristocrat in 1947. Changed over to Chess, I want to say around 1948. Yeah, 1948.
I am a natural born lover. Treat you in a lover world.
Definitely. The late great Muddy Waters. Born April 4th, 1915. Sadly passed away April 30th, 1983. Heart attack, 68 years old. But I'll tell you what, he still lives on today. This comes from my 9 CD, 205 song box set I picked up for $34.77 back in 1996, I believe it was. An outlet store in California. CD Red Box number 3. Complete. Got the complete released output for the Chess label, with exception of Super Blues Sessions from 1967. All right. Well, folks, got friends coming over, so it is time to make like a fetus and head out. So everybody take care. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. You might spill your drink or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. And what's dumber than that is root for douchebag cocksuckers like Eli and as good as Tom Brady Manning. Ugh. Or men slapping women. That's just plain stupid. All right, folks. I'm out of here. See you all tomorrow. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Bye-bye. Bye.